Christina Bunkley Valley.
Only this conservative government says giving a Canadian $15 an hour is somehow a job-killing initiative. Yesterday, the Prime Minister was off again brunching in New York with rich bankers, bragging about the alleged strength of the Canadian economy. Well, Mr. Speaker, the Emperor's got no clothes, as disturbing as that image may be. The reality is, more and more Canadians are being forced into low-wage, part-time jobs. The OECD shows this, that the Conservative government is one of the worst in the world on this. Does the minister actually brag about the fact that nearly one quarter of all jobs in Canada are now low-wage and precarious? Is this something to brag about to the world?
The Honourable Minister of State.
Well, again, Mr. Speaker, Canadians are better off under our Conservative government. And certainly, Mr. Speaker, Canadian families in all income groups have seen increases about 10% in their take-home pay. The lowest income families have seen an increase of 14%, Mr. Speaker. For the first time, again, middle-income Canadians are better off than Americans. The median net worth of Canadian families has increased by 45% since we have taken office, Mr. Speaker. It's the facts that the opposition refuses to look at.
The Honourable Member for Skeena Vokey Valley.
Right through the Conservative spin, and because they are facing the reality of a job market that is not meeting the needs. The conference board shows that there's a serious and growing income gap between older workers and younger workers. Under this Conservative government, it's getting harder for older workers to retire and more difficult for younger workers to get into the market in the first place. So how about you? One positive thing. Why don't we give Canadians a raise? Raise the federal minimum wage, as the NDP has suggested. Give Canadians who are working hard, working full-time, but living below the poverty line, a break for once.
The Honourable Minister of State.
Well, again, Mr. Speaker, the member knows that the economy of Canada is the economy that is envied by most countries around the world. Over 1.1 million net new jobs have been created in this country since the deepest part of the recession. Mr. Speaker, overwhelmingly, the majority of those are in the private sector and are full-time jobs. Mr. Speaker, we've invested, he talks about youth, we've invested $330 million per year through the Youth Employment Strategy. We've supported more paid internships for recent post-secondary graduates. We understand the importance of skill development to